I get grumpy so much of the time. When little things happen, they just get under my skin. I don't know about you, but like the internet went down the other morning and it was frustrating me and I was just like, ooh. Or maybe I'm baking and I, accidentally drop a whole bunch of flour on the floor and I'm like, oh, I just get so irritable. Or maybe an unexpected bill comes in the mail from the doctor's office or whatever you thought insurance was going to cover it and you're like, oh, I'm just so frustrated. And if my husband happens to walk by at that moment, whew, he suffers collateral damage. Collateral damage is a military term. It means, when the civilians in the area are unintentionally harmed because of kind of like the spray of bullets or the spray of the explosions that were used or whatever, the explosives that were used. Collateral damage. You didn't intend for it to happen, but they're kind of in the spray zone of the weaponry. Well, sometimes when I am irritable and grouchy because of whatever's going on in my life, and my husband walks by, I mean, he has collateral damage of like the darts that are coming out of my eyes or the bullets that are coming out of my mouth. Do you know what I mean? So how do we stop doing this kind of thing to our husband and stop inflicting this collateral damage? Well, here are two different thoughts. Number one, pause before you react. Here's the thing. Your husband is not the enemy. Your children who are present when you get all irritable, they're not the enemy. The enemy is Satan, and he is looking to provoke you. But if you'll pause, that's going to take some of the wind out of his sails. I think of 1 Peter 5, verses 8 and 9, that says, "Be alert and self-controlled. Your enemy, the devil, prowls around looking for someone to devour. Resist him, standing firm in the faith." Part of the way you resist is to pause before you give vent to your frustration and irritation. And secondly, you can claim some specific Bible promises. I think of Isaiah 54:17. No weapon forged against you will prevail. Sometimes I just claim that. No weapon forged against me will prevail. A promise from God. And then I like to claim Romans 8:28. And we know that in all things, God works together for good for those who are called according to his purpose. And so I'm like, Lord, I don't know why the internet is down. I don't know why I got this bill in the mail. I don't know why I just dropped all the flour on the floor. But can you make something good out of this? Because you said you can work all things together for good.